threats are evolving. How to balance them?
Yes, threats are evolving. I mean, we've seen the trends over time. And as we talked about earlier on a panel here at WCIT, threats are going to follow the money trail. And so part of the issue that we have as organizations is understanding, you know, do I need to be concerned with all of the threats and how they evolve, or should I look inside to be a resilient organization? There's a threat side and there's a consequence side. Part of what we're teaching at Carnegie Mellon is that while we need to use the threat to inform the actions that we take, we really should be looking at consequence. Because when we look at cyber threat, that's only one aspect of the threat for the organization. There are other threats. There's the threat of the people who are working for you making mistakes. There's the threat of a natural disaster. There are lots of different types of threats other than just a cyber threat. So instead, looking at the consequence to your organization, what could happen, what if something does go bad, what will happen to my organization, and focusing my efforts on those things that are most critical to achieving my mission, that's really a great way to, instead of just incorporate threat in what's evolving, to look at the consequence so that you're a resilient organization.
So what you're saying basically is to have a holistic view of the organization and to treat them all. Are companies in that level?
So unfortunately not. Right now, companies are still looking at cybersecurity as an information technology issue. It's not. It's absolutely a holistic enterprise issue. Everything from policy and HR, you know, human resources, all the way through operations of your organization. So you do need to look at the enterprise level of your organization, looking across all of the functions that you have. And don't treat cybersecurity as an IT activity. One of the things that we discuss is making cybersecurity a part of your culture, fostering a culture of security so that it permeates the entire organization.
And I'm aware that companies can have a large budget and just a few budgets. And what do you think it's more critical, and what should they address in the first place?
So a great place to start, and it's one of the principles that we discussed today, is starting with a risk assessment, an enterprise risk assessment, because we can't make improvements if we don't know where we are today. There are lots and lots of models and frameworks out there. It can be overwhelming, but selecting an assessment methodology and doing an enterprise assessment of your organization enables you to say, this is where we stand. This is the baseline of where we are, and you have to make decisions on where you want to go. You're not going to be able to cover everything. So looking at things like asset management, identity management, third-party risk, and identifying which of those are the most critical for your organization and how mature you want to be at those capabilities, that can help you understand where you are today, where you want to go, and the steps that you need to take in between.
We talk about a lot about the cyber attacks, but I think social engineering involved a lot in the recent years. And are companies prepared for that? Are they taking enough time or working on this?
I think, unfortunately, right now we're still looking at cybersecurity as a technical capability in trying to solve the problem with tools. And really, your biggest asset is also your biggest liability, and that's people. And so we have to train people. We have to make an investment in our workforce that they need to understand cybersecurity. They need to understand not the intricacies, but what is each person's responsibility within the organization. Social engineering is still the number one attack method, and it can be done as part of kits that are bought. Very unsophisticated attacks can have very detrimental results. And so absolutely, social engineering is an issue. It will not be solved with technology alone, and it has to be solved with some training.
Do you think that millennials getting into companies start to working are making it easier or more difficult?
I don't have any exact statistics on that, but I would say that the threat surface, the attack surface, is bigger with millennials because they are more connected. So, for example, my parents' generation and even my generation, we don't use technology as pervasively, or we didn't in the past, as millennials and others are. So the attack surface is just bigger with millennials. I don't have statistics on whether or not they are putting us more at risk or not, though.